Hello everyone, Trix here, and welcome to The Legend of Zelda Link's Awakening, part 28. We are at the file selection screen, and you might ask, what the hell are we doing here? Well, I promised there were a couple of things with the name-giving when you select a new game. And I thought, I completely forgot about showing that off, and I need to do it at some point, so might as well do it now that I'm still thinking about it. There's a couple of Easter eggs they put in here. You can compare it to the very first Zelda, where if you named yourself Zelda, you would be able to do the second quest and everything. But in here, you also have a couple of things. The first one being like in the very first one, so might as well show that off immediately. Call yourself Zelda. And this happens. A cool little arrangement of the Zelda Overworld theme starts playing. Fun little Easter egg. You can still play the game as Zelda if you call yourself Zelda, obviously, because okay is still an option. But this little music starts playing. But don't think that is the only one. Call yourself after the main character beside Link in this game, Marin. And this happens. A cool little remix of the Ballad of the Windfish, the most important song in this game. Which you just can listen to on the file select screen just by calling yourself Marin. But the most important Easter egg, that was one B too many, is, like in a lot of games, Totaka. Call yourself Totakeke. After the famous composer Totaka. And we get this game's rendition of Totaka's song. As you might know, or if you don't know, I'll explain. Totaka is a Japanese composer who makes video game music for certain games. This is also a game he worked on. And in all of those games, he puts this song, which is basically his Easter egg song. In some of the games is really well hidden, but it is always present in those games. In this case, by calling yourself Totakeke on the file selection screen, Totaka's song becomes available here. Pretty fun, huh? Cool little Easter eggs. Not really that noteworthy when it comes to clearing the game, but it is part of the game, so I thought I might as well show it off these first 3 minutes in a video. Alright, we were doing dungeon arranging. I'll see you I'll see you there. Alright, this one is annoying. I don't like this one. The shape is so weird. You can see what it is, an ocarina. Let's see, dungeon song. Your ocarina gave me the idea for this one. Think of the arranging like writing a song. The more you put in, the prettier it is. Of course, a real ocarina packed with stuff doesn't play. I'll see you when I'm done arranging. Alright, here we go. One little quick note. While I made this, I noticed one of the tiles that was already placed was a boss fight room. A And because of the room I have beside it, I actually made it like this, that I can just simply skip this boss room. Because as you can see, by the room to the right, to the bottom right, and to the bottom of it, I made this room skippable. So you don't have to do this boss fight. And there was, of course, the staircase that I had to put in, so I just simply made a small little different area with the boss and everything, so this is what it ended up being. There's a couple of tips I can give with the dungeon arranging. Right, first I need to go right, because right is dead end, but it has chests, so this I'm going to do first. What am I going to talk about today? Do I have a topic available? Of course not. I do everything without script, as you may know by now. What can I think of? Oh, last time we talked about Zelda Remix. Let's talk about Zelda spin-offs this time. Spin-offs. Zelda is, of course, a pretty well-known, well-renowned series up to this point. With a very big, wide scala of mainstream games we have been gotten through the past. 19, I believe, right now. 20, if you count the Breath of the Wild sequel that has been announced a while back, even though we haven't seen too much of that quite yet, other than the initial reveal. But Zelda is more than just mainstream games. There's the occasional spin-off game here or there. And what are my thoughts about those, you may ask? Well, that's what I'm here to talk about. I have not played all of them. That's what I'm going to say right now. Not every single Zelda spin-off is in my possession and is engraved in my brain for that. I have some of them. And the one that sticks to my mind the most is most definitely Hyrule Warriors. The Dynasty Warriors-esque game by Koei Tecmo that has been released on the Wii U at first. It has been re-released twice now, even though the original game was, what was it again, 2015 or something, or 14? And it already got released three times. Pretty weird, actually. This game took over 20 years to release three times, and Hyrule Warriors did it in no less than 4 years. re-released on the 3DS, and it also re-released on the Switch under Hyrule Warriors Legends and Hyrule Warriors Definitive Edition, respectively. And yeah, I can say that in all three versions of that game, yeah, I was stupid enough to buy all three of them. In all three versions of that game, I have spent over 400 hours, I think. The Wii version I spent the most time in, because me being stupid enough to trying to get max level with all of the characters there, I actually leveled everybody up to level 255 there. It took for freaking ever. I never did that in Legends and Definitive Edition, of course, because I liked the game enough to say that I wanted to buy it again and again when it re-released a couple of times. But I never went 100% with the games again. I just completely cleared everything in the story and adventure modes and everything, and didn't go for max level everything. I did not go for max weapons. I did not go for max. What else did I skip? I know there was something else I dropped. Oh yeah, the fairy stuff. There was the fairy stuff that got introduced there. I also didn't do that. And achievements. There's a lot of achievements. I did do all of the achievements in the Wii version, including the DLC. But that's where it stopped for me. But besides that, I still managed to make over 200 hours in the Definitive Edition, just clearing the story mode and clearing the adventure mode, all of the maps. That still took me over 200 hours. So I definitely, with that, come on, why did the shield didn't work? There we go. But definitely, even though it is a Zelda spin-off title, it is the Zelda game that I definitely played the most. With all the time I made in that game, went over all the time I made in games I've played 1,000 times, like Ocarina of Time, like A Link to the Past, like Majora's Mask. Went completely over it. But yeah, it is an RPG, it's a JRPG, so the game is definitely suited for those long tracks. JRPGs are meant to be very, very long-esque games when it comes to time you have to put in it in order to do everything in that. Because like all other RPGs, it is not really that big of a game. It's just, it takes a very, very long time to do everything in it because of the slow pace that RPGs tend to have. And that is mostly where the time went into. And you know me, I always like to completely clear everything in a game, so I still felt obligated to do everything in that game. And that is mostly where the time came out of. Still don't know how I'm going to cover that in Let's Play, to be honest, because RPGs are really tough to Let's Play. That's a wall I have bumped myself into in a couple of times already. I can already give that away without spoiling too much. Yes, I have been teasing around with RPG Let's Plays for a minute in order to see how that is going to work. I do have a couple of plans. Don't think that I have thought of no, RPGs is too hard to make Let's Plays out of, so I'm not going to do it. I do have a couple of plans still. I did have to drop a lot of them. I will not be playing RPGs a lot on my channel. I'm going to be sorry for that in advance. But it's not like I'm going to completely let them fall. Some of them I've decided to simply not 100%, or just do partially, because they take way, way, way too long to do. There's way too many one-sided things in it. It becomes way too repetitive quickly. So I do have some tweaking around with that. But it is still planned, but because I've been trying around a couple of things in a couple of RPGs to try to figure out how I'm going to handle that when the Let's Plays are coming, because one of them is not too far in the future at this point, so I wanted to have that cleared out for myself. But it's going to be a toughie. So Hyrule Warriors also being one of them, even it's also a hack and slash game, kill everything on screen kind of game, but it's also a JRPG, of course. But I'm not too sure how I'm going to handle that one. That one is going to be a toughie. That's all I can say for now. But I'm not going to skip out on it. Don't worry about that. Let's go talk about some different spin-offs now. Hyrule Warriors is by far my most important one. But it's not the only... Dang it. Need to blow this up. Did not know there was a cracked wall there. One of the most infamous ones. And with infamous, I mean it in a negative sense. But some other known Zelda spin-offs, probably the first ones actually, that people know of, are... How did I screw that up? I might as well get this chest. Now that I'm here. One of the most infamous spin-offs from early days are in the time that Nintendo more oftenly decided to give away some of their rights to other companies to make Zelda games. And also, the most important reason they don't do it anymore, because it went completely haywire when they did it with that company. And I'm talking about Philips and their CDI, the Zelda CDI games. What were they called again? The Wand of Gamelon is one of them. There is the Faces of Evil. I believe the Faces of Evil was the first one, actually. Then there was the Wand of Gamelon, and there was Zelda's Adventure. Those three games that are released on the Philips CDI mid-90s. And Nintendo stupidly gave away the rights to make Zelda. It was in the time between Link's Awakening and Ocarina of Time, the big gap that Nintendo did not make Zeldas on their own. And they decided other companies can make them if they want to. And they gave away their rights to Philips. And the biggest abominations in video game history were born. I have not played those games myself. But of course, as a gamer, I have been able to see a couple of things about that, because I never owned a CDI, that's the reason I never owned them. And in all honesty, I really don't have the motivation to play them, in all honesty, because they absolutely look terrible. People still play them and... People still play them and have some funny moments with them, some memes with them, because of their silliness, because the games are so ridiculously bad that it becomes funny. That's why people still tend to play them, but it is... Bobby, you're playing the wrong Zelda. But it is still definitely a part of Zelda history. I'll be talking about it more when I am done arranging the next dungeon, by the way. Because fast forwarding is coming. House of the Hinox. It is a quickie because of being a speedrun. But still. There's a bunch of those beefy Hinoxes around here. It gets worse too. You've only got 3 minutes to finish the adventure. Don't know how to handle Hinoxes? Then keep an eye on your hearts. With that he means just blaze through them. Don't worry about being careful. Worry about being fast. Right, and this is enough. As small as it may seem, it is pretty tough actually, because this room is a Hinox, and it's a forced one. This room is another Hinox. This room is another Hinox. And the boss is Genie, the boss that takes by far the longest. So the 3 minute time limit you get here is actually pretty limited. Be careful and be fast. This is actually... not in the special missions for nothing. This is pretty tough. So, be fast. Don't be careful, just be fast. Go down. Yeah, talking about Zelda spin-offs. Those Zelda CDI games, I won't be elaborating about them too much because I haven't played them myself yet. And I don't think I'm going to. I don't even know how I would play them in all honesty because... getting a CDI and getting those games with them, pretty much impossible. But those games are so freakingly bad that they are actually pretty hilarious. And that's what most people get their fun out of those games. Because gameplay-wise, those are games you don't want to play. They're so bad. Yeah, Nintendo found that out, so they decided never to really give away their rights to create a Zelda game. Ever again. Unless it is actually a company that you can take seriously, like they later did with Capcom. Capcom is a company you can trust. You don't have to worry about Capcom. But in all honesty, besides that, they actually never really did that. Until Hyrule Warriors came around. And there's of course still the Tingle games. Talking about spin-offs, you can't forget about the Tingle games that really, most notably Tingle's Rosie Rupee Land. That is a game that's actually still on my backlog. I do have some intention of playing those at some point, I just never got around to it. But you all know Tingle, the guy that got introduced in Majora's Mask in 2000. A guy that is very well known and notorious and infamous and everything you want to call it. Yeah, as you can see, the Hinox part of this dungeon is quite quickly doable. I did it within 1 minute, but this guy actually takes a lot of time because you can't really cheese this guy. You actually have to wait for him to do his cycle before you can actually engage him. And that is actually the case in both of the phases for this guy. I'm still pretty surprised that this guy is actually the second boss in the game. Would have been... believable if he would have been a later boss, in all honesty. But still, it is the guy that takes the longest, so they didn't place him here for nothing. Right, and then there's one more Zelda title I really like to talk about quickly, and that is BS Legend of Zelda. because of it not being an official Zelda title when it comes to the mainstream, you can consider it a spin-off title. BS Legend of Zelda is actually a Satellaview game that, like F-Zero, which I already covered on my channel, so that I can take as an example. But The Legend of Zelda is actually a title that also got a release on the Satellaview, that actually got a broadcast. And it is an SNES remake of the original Legend of Zelda. And it might be a little bit fun to check that out at some point as well. Because I have a way to play some Satellaview games on emulator and everything. So I might be able to take a look at that at some point as well. So that is also a title I'd like to cover at some point. But for now, I think those are the Zelda spin-offs I have in my mind right now. The CDI Zeldas are definitely ones I'm not going to play. Let's see how this fits. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, or 7 left. Yeah, because of the 3-minute introduction I have with the name-giving Easter egg, I think this is enough. I think the time is up. I think we're at 20 minutes right now. So this other speedrun is going to be for next time. I'll try to have another topic ready, talking more about Zeldas. I have one more topic which I can think of. I think I'll be talking about that. It's kind of a successor to a topic I had talked about a while back when I talked about tediousness and hard difficulty in Zelda games. I think I'll continue my story on that when I take that one step beyond. So I'll see you next time for that. And the next couple of missions will be played while I'll be talking about that. Beginning with this speedrun. And I already see a couple of staircases in here. Not going to be fun. Thanks for watching, and Trix out.